We'll keep you posted on this game, but we're getting set now for the tip out in Lexington. Back to Dick Stockton and Al McGuire. It's time for Wake Forest in Kansas. Take it away, gentlemen.
Between the Wake Forest Demon Deacons and welcome back to Rupp Arena in Lexington, Kentucky. Second round action in the Southeast region between the second team, Wake Forest, the Demon Deacons seeded number 5, and Kansas number 4. It'll be ACC against Big 8, and the winner will take on Purdue in Knoxville in the Sweet 16 next week. Hello again, everyone. Along with Al McGuire, I'm Dick Stockton. Kansas was a national power early. They slumped, and if they're going to be overlooked now, that could be a mistake for a lot of teams because they're playing well with outstanding depth, good defense, and rebounding. And no one epitomizes it more, Al, than Steve Woodberry, who not only is the leading scorer for the Jayhawks, but their top defender as well. Woodberry, a key man for Kansas. What does he have to do today for the Jayhawks?
Well, I think, first of all, he has to hit from out. He has to drain a few early in the ball game. Second, he must commit no more than 3 turnovers. Very, very important point. And third, he has to take Childress out of his normal game.
And you're talking about Randolph Childress, and Wake Forest had to rally to beat College of Charleston in the first round, but they have knocked off some giants. 2 times over Duke, they beat North Carolina as well, but the key man always for them is Randolph Childress.
He's a number 2 guard. He wants to take the pressure shot. If he has a problem, and I think it's a major problem, he's too unselfish.
Okay, what do you think of the matchup of this game, round 2?
To cover the whole game, it's a 10-man rotation against a 7-man rotation. The Jayhawks will try to giddy it up, and Wake Forest will try to slow it down.
All right. It's as plain as that. Let's bring in the starting lineup. Trelawney Owens, Tim Duncan, Mark Lucas, and the 2 guards, Childress and Charlie Harrison. For Kansas, they're going to once again start Sean Pearson in place of Patrick Ritchie. Richard Scott, the big man, Greg Ostertag in the middle, and besides Steve Woodberry in the backcourt, Jacques Vaughn. But you're going to see many substitutions coming early and often. Roy Williams in his 6th year as head coach of Kansas. And Dave Odom, the ACC Coach of the Year. And until Odom arrived at Wake Forest in 1990, Wake Forest had never gone to the NCAA tournament more than 2 years in a row. This is their 4th season in succession going to the big dance. Favorites coming in at 26-7. Wake Forest 21-11. The Jayhawks went over 100 points. They scored 102 points. And when you consider the great history of the Jayhawks in this tournament, their 102 points were the most ever by a Kansas team in 70 NCAA tournament contests.
Every time you play there in Allen Fieldhouse, it's like a flashback. It's what basketball is all about.
The Demon Deacons of Wake Forest. They held Charleston to 35% shooting, and they need that again today against Kansas. The officials working this game, Jody Sylvester, Frank Bassoni, and Bob Garibaldi. Kansas will be in white, and Wake Forest in gold. And it'll be Ostertag jumping against Duncan.
Wake Forest must box out. If they don't box out, it'll be a long afternoon.
Tip control by the Jayhawks. Plays like a freshman. Here is Woodberry, hits the first shot of the game, averaging 15 a game.
Start the pressure right off with that great freshman.
Now Childress working against Vaughn, put a good move on Vaughn. He threw up the air ball, but he made a nice move.
Alley-oop to Pearson, nope, made eye contact, didn't finalize in that play.
Ostertag, not get to play much in round 1, he got into early foul trouble. This team can pass well.
Scott's going up with it.
And he's got it. In the first game of the tournament, Kansas had 33 assists. That tied for 3rd, the most in NCAA tournament history. So this is an unselfish, very fine passing team.
Jones has to start right now. He can't wait 5 or 6 minutes. He has to do it right now. And Vaughn's an unbelievable defensive player. As a freshman, he's the leader of the team as far as the holler guy and the leader.
It's amazing. They all feed off of Vaughn, despite the fact that he's a freshman. Missing from the corner was Duncan. And here comes Kansas leading 4-0. Look inside for Scott. Scott coming off a career game. And he misses that time from the baseline. Here comes Wake. Two good guards in Harrison and Childress. They don't go deep, as Al mentioned. Only seven men off the bench.
Harrison wanted that ball. He's the one that truly won the Providence game with two outside bombs in the second half.
Three-guard offense, and Lucas is the other man. There's the turnover, and here is Vaughn. Defender is back, but Woodberry puts up the jumper, and Kansas has scored the first 6 points of the game.
Need a scratch. Need to get off the snide. This time down. Look for a foul. It bumped heads.
And they call it against Childress. They call the offensive foul despite the fact Childress got hit.
Watch Vaughn and the steal here. Very quick hands. And off to the races. Did a hockey move right there. Controlled the ball. You know he's going to kick back to Woodberry. Now, here's where he bumped heads. I don't think a foul should have been called there. It just should have been an injury timeout.
Kansas already going to the bench. Scot Pollard, a freshman, 6'11", who played outstanding in place of Ostertag, who had foul trouble. Here's Pearson cutting through the lane. Pollard trying to keep it alive, and Duncan gets the rebound. Duncan, one of the outstanding young players, a freshman from St. Croix and Virgin Islands, will have his hands full against the big giants of the Jayhawks.
That last possession saved the timeout for Wake Forest, because if Kansas gets ahead by eight, you can't wait for the commercial timeout, which is still a minute and a half away.
Kansas started their game against University of Tennessee Chattanooga leading 9-0. They scored the first 6 points in this game.
Scot has nice position. He's going to muscle Duncan.
And they'll call Scot with the offensive foul.
Yeah, there's too much muscling underneath there. He's too strong for the freshman.
Roy Williams, a disciple, of course, of Dean Smith. A lot of people think someday he's going to go back to Chapel Hill. I don't know when Dean is ever going to step down.
Well, it'd be another guy being consideration, Eddie Fogler, but I think Roy Williams has the inside lane. Another guy would be Larry Brown, surprisingly. I think they all dream because they're a family at North Carolina. Mm-hmm. That should be two.
Childress, it is two. Cut around, Vaughn. They set a good pick, and Vaughn got caught in it, so Wake Forest gets on the board after more than 3 minutes of this first half.
We're better when Harrison takes the ball down and Childress comes off the baseline.
Pollard off the glass. Owens the rebound. Trelawney Owens did not have a good game. He had a season's low of only 7 points, only made one basket, and Wake Forest has to get, besides Childress, Owens in the game.
Owens is due.
Double team. Owens from the baseline. And the rebound pulled down by Woodberry.
Now Wake Forest wants to work the clock. Jayhawks want to giddy up.
Pearson leaning in. Rebound by Duncan. Interesting that Kansas used to be a powerful offensive team, but they've gone more to the defensive side with rebounding. Lucas hits a three. Well, they took him out because he was reluctant to shoot in game one. Not now.
We got ourselves a game. It could have been a blowout early. Wake got the break and matching the almost the 6 points. They got five. So you should have a game this first half real strong. Don't forget, they play the North Carolinas. They play the Dukes. They're used to playing the number ones in the country.
Vaughn misses the three, and Lucas gets the rebound. He fought it away from Pearson. So Wake Forest trailing 6-0 in the early going. Now faced with looking at possibly their first lead of the game. Go into Duncan. Good move around Pollard. What a move by Tim Duncan, who's averaging nearly 10 a game.
Pollard forgot to move his feet. Defense is played with your feet.
Wake Forest has run off seven in a row after the Jayhawks scored the first 6 points of this game. Nearly 5 minutes elapsed.
If I was Pollard, I'd take Duncan down low because his body isn't there yet. Take a number of years before that one to be built up.
Scott's the man the Jayhawks have posting up inside. Having trouble finding Pollard because of Duncan. Woodberry misses a three. Long rebound. Stepping on the line was Pearson. Well, after an early slow start, Wake has come back.
How we doing?
Dave needs to see you.
I'll be right there.
Hey, Ron.
Brad, man, how you doing?
All right.
Brad Johnson has a lot to think about.
Where's my table?
Dave needs in the kitchen right now.
That's why he chose AT&T. Competitive prices without the hassle is his AT&T business advantage.
Hey, Joey, get the big five.
What's up, Dave?
Got problems.
plumber.
So what does Brad think about his long-distance service now? He doesn't.
AT&T works for me.
Let AT&T work for you.
I hear you're the competitive type.
No.
But you might be surprised to find out that the Oldsmobile Cutlass Sierra Special Edition with anti-lock brakes, airbag, air conditioning, and more is over $4,000 less than the Ford Taurus GL. Which leads me to believe, shouldn't their saying be, have you priced a Ford lately? Yeah, about $4,000 worth. It's your money.
Ms. Carpenito?
Oh, that's right. Carpenito Travel. Mm. Need a vacation?
No.
Hawaii, Jamaica.
Listen, we understand you'd like to purchase a new HP LaserJet 4P.
Sure, I heard it'll make my packages look better.
And that's important to you, right?
Well, yeah, I put a lot into them.
Oh, and you'll need a new 600 DPI printer.
As many DPIs as I can get. Just think how good your itinerary will look.
Well, there you go. You need an HP LaserJet 4P.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Now, where are we going to send you on vacation?
HP LaserJet printers. You do your job, we'll do ours.
Dude Ranch.
I'm allergic to dudes.
NAPA, we're the most complete source for auto parts, and all NAPA parts are backed by a nationwide warranty program. No wonder more Americans trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
New from Pizza Hut, the ultimate pepperoni pizza. With zesty herbs and spices and thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste. This is the ultimate pepperoni pizza. But remember, one bite and there's no going back.
He was not the monster that the world made him out to be.
It takes someone like that to believe the Holocaust never happened. 60 Minutes, Sunday.
Watch this. Dave knows what those 7 points meant. They were on the ropes this early in the game. He has such a thin bench. He's touching everybody. He is now hugging. Maybe later in the game he'll go through the whip. A coach is always trying to make a boy a man.
But not a man a boy.
No, no, you always let the guy take one more step, and if he takes that step, one more forever.
Stan King in the lineup for Wake Forest. Trelawney Owens with a turnaround, so he's still getting off to the slow start. B.J. Williams in the game with Patrick Ritchie. Ritchie, who has been the starter but had a hip pointer in the Big 8 tournament, did not start in the first round either, but here he is. Ostertag for Pollard, trying that extra tip, and trying to keep it alive is Ritchie. Wake has the ball and a one-point lead.
Just trying to steal some time here with King.
Harrison, he hit a couple of big threes against College of Charleston. Kansas has missed its last six shots. Trying to get untracked again, but Wake Forest grinded out defensive unit.
Watch King try to neutralize the strength of Ostertag underneath. I think too much motion on King that time. He's only out there to commit some fouls. They're not one-on-one. He's trying to neutralize. Who'd they call that foul on, Dick?
It was on Stan King.
Oh, it was on King. I thought so.
Yeah, so you called it. It was.
It's always out different.
He's a senior from Jamaica, New York, a senior. He did not play in the first round.
Now he did his job. Back he goes to the bench.
Duncan comes back in, and one of the top reserves, and maybe the best reserve, is Travis Scooter Banks, who scored five rebounds in 16 minutes in the first round.
Banks has a strong body, and they show you a 2-3 zone.
Woodberry hits a three. So Woodberry leads the team in three-point baskets. He's got 7 of the 9 Kansas points.
Three-guard offense.
Childress hits from outside.
We are playing the Wake Forest game.
They're slowing it up. They're controlling the pace. One thing that Dave Odom said, we got to watch the transition with the quick guards. Ostertag, they're going to try and get it in. Ostertag, who has a lot of beef against Tim Duncan, despite the fact that they're both up there. Ostertag is 7-1. Duncan 6-10. 11-10 Kansas. And a foul called. It may be Williams or Woodberry against Charlie Harrison.
When you're playing against a body that Duncan has on Wake Forest and you're Ostertag, you're 7-1, but all of a sudden you're 7-6 because the body makes you taller and Duncan's body makes him shorter.
Greg Gurley replaces Woodberry for Kansas. Gurley, an outstanding three-point shooter. If he's on, he's dangerous, but he can be streaky. Rayford also in the game in the backcourt, number 10. 5'7" out of Milwaukee, Al's hometown. Good pass into Duncan. Couldn't convert. He had Ostertag in his face, and Richie comes down with it. Kansas leading by one.
In that situation, you go for the dunk. Ostertag is too big.
Gurley, Ostertag, Richie, Rayford trying to set a pick. Player there is B.J. Williams, and it was against Kansas, and the foul is against Rayford, number one for him.
Yeah, Calvin did set an illegal screen that time.
Owens replaces Harrison. So right now, Rusty LaRue comes in as the second guard. They're going to use two guards up front and three men up front, unlike their normal arrangement of three guards. Here's LaRue. He doesn't mind taking the threes. LaRue was 2-for-9 against the College of Charleston. And a foul against Wake Forest.
That was on Timmy, I believe.
That was on Owens, Trelawney Owens. So each team has three fouls. At 8 minutes gone by in the first half, winner gets Purdue at Knoxville next week. Purdue defeated Alabama 83-73 in our first game. Good steal by Harrison. He stripped Ostertag. That's Childress. Childress for three. Banks. LaRue. He hits it. Keep trying, LaRue.
By LaRue.
Former quarterback of the football team started five games for the Demon Deacons. Wake by two and another turnover. Banks is fouled by Richie from behind, and that'll be the fourth team foul against the Jayhawks.
Foul is on Richie, his first.
Dave Odom's Wake Forest Demon Deacons leading with 11:29 to go.
In some ways, picking the winner of this championship is like buying a new car. So many to choose from, but how do you know for sure? Well, we were thinking more like some independent test results, which showed that the Oldsmobile 88 LSS ran neck and neck for 100,000 miles with the Acura Legend L and Lexus ES300. We said it'd be an easy decision. It's your money.
Maybe it's because their frames are welded instead of bolted. Or because their decks are stamped from a single piece of steel. Or maybe it's the fact that they have the highest resale value in the industry.
Oh, hey, I always wanted one of these. Thanks.
But the truth is, when people are asked what kind of lawn tractor they'd like as a gift, most say the same thing. Just a reminder, if you're talking basketball, Foot Locker speaks your language.
At the top, come on, meet me at the top.
Well, most of it. Foot Locker, official corporate partner for the NCAA championships.
We invented light beer, made the rules.
This must be the front row.
We can change them. Introducing new light ice from Miller. Ice brewed and less filling. 100% ice brewed for a taste that's more of what you want. Definitely light for less of what you don't.
New beer. New rules. How you doing?
New light ice from Miller.
This week on Dave, Bill Cosby, Diane Sawyer, Neil Diamond, L. McPherson, and Rosie O'Donnell. This week.
It's been a remarkable year for Wake Forest when you consider how they lost Rodney Rogers, who left after his junior year, and they also lost Maktar Injai, who is ineligible now with Michigan. Got a big basket against Pepperdine and Ricardo Parral. This team could have been really strong, and what do you do? Odom got them together, kept them together, and here they are in the second round.
And that Parral is from Spain.
And they call the foul against Kansas. For Kansas, it'll be their 15th foul.
Roy Williams may have a headache. That's Pearson with his first foul of the game. And for Kansas, they making substitutions upon substitutions. They just made them, and then 2 seconds later, another one. There have been 14 subs already in for Kansas.
That's their M.O., multiple substitutions, especially the first half.
Trapping Trelawney Owens, Childress has LaRue, Lucas, so the three guards back in there for Wake Forest. Duncan and Owens up front.
Pearson's too tall. Childress can dribble around if he keeps his dribble alive.
And Owens with the baseline shot. He had a good chance. 0 for 4 for Trelawney Owens, who had only one basket, but it was a big one in the latter stages. LaRue nearly forced a turnover. Let's check in who's in for Kansas right now. They've got Pollard, Woodberry, Pearson, Rayford, and Vaughn and Scott. But you know what? He just said something to me during the break. He knows who his good ones are, right?
Oh yeah, as you get down to the the key time of the game, you want to go to your best five, six guys. But still, he'll stay with his multiple substitutions in the first half. Second half, he'll adjust, but the game is still tight. The game is being played the way the Demon Deacons want it to be played.
Looks like they're doing a good job of it. Here is Scott, tries to pass into Pollard. Banging the boards, out to Childress. 3-on-2 for Wake Forest. It's there for him, and Lucas with a reverse layoff. Layup, and Wake Forest leads by 4, and that's their biggest lead.
Classic break. Three guards on that break. Should automatically be a layup.
For the starters, the only difference is the center, Pollard for Ostertag. And a very nice baby hook from the baseline, and it's a two-point game.
A lot of people forget that Pollard's only a freshman.
Three outstanding freshmen for Kansas, led by the top newcomer in the league, Jacques Vaughn. Pollard and B.J. Williams, the other.
The three of them are absolutely blue chippers.
Childress gets it low to Duncan. But Duncan really got raved as the season went on.
Well, they had to put him out there because of kid had a transfer, the other one was ineligible, and one that had to sit out.
Scott, tough play. He had a defender in front of him, one behind him. So the pace is picking up. That's a good sign for Kansas. Wake Forest wants to slow it down. They're leading by 2.
They want 3 to score so bad. Just can't get it done.
He's getting the shot. He's getting the good percentage shot, but they're not falling. 0 for 5 from the field. Jacques Vaughn, Scott following. Kansas is getting their chance on the offensive boards, and that was something that was going to worry Odom.
Randolph will back it up, look for the three-point play.
I like Wake Forest boys out there. Yeah. 5 seconds. Words are no sooner out of my mouth, but you couldn't find someone to pass it to. Charlie Harrison returns to the lineup, replacing Randolph Childress. Ostertag back in for Kansas. So far, Childress with 5 and Lucas with 5 are the leading scorers for Wake. Woodberry has 7 to top Kansas.
Wake Forest has the luxury to go multiple substitutions. So when you want to rest, they normally go to a zone defensively, but you can really rest on offense and work in the clock down for the three-guard offense.
Woodberry off the screen. And let's see, no basket. Interfered on the cylinder by Ostertag.
I think they both interfered, Richie and Ostertag that time. Ostertag came over Richie's back here. Watch. Richie has the inside position. His teammate.
Yep. Wake Forest leading by 2. Kansas scored the first 6 points of the game. And there is Harrison. Not known for his offense, but he gave him plenty of that in the first round against Charleston.
And as most people know, he's a transfer from Georgetown. There's the zone I was talking about.
19 to 15, so Wake Forest again matches their biggest lead, 4 points. They scored 7 in a row after Kansas opened the game by tallying 6. Here's Richie hitting the 3.
3-point basket.
He puts you to sleep, Dick. He can hit him out there.
Patrick Richie got off to a good start in round 1. He hit 2 threes to start the game for Kansas in their victory over UTC. Owens is guarded by the freshman, B.J. Williams here. Open is Lucas for 3. Duncan keeps it alive. Again, Lucas is open. He's missed 2 wide open threes. 19 to 18 in favor of Wake and a blocking foul.
More out of frustration, missing those two open threes in a row. I thought the second time with the new clock, he should have melted. He's yelling at himself now. He knows he made a mistake.
That is the 13th foul against Wake Forest. And we're going to have a timeout. 7:43 remaining in the first half. It's Nip and Tuck.
The Women's Final Four coming soon on CBS.
We're ball players and we're okay. We're not fat and lazy like the bonus say. In spring we train real hard.
Yeah.
So we look good on our baseball card.
They're ball players or so they say. They'd rather be doing ads for Bengay.
If they ain't in shape, they don't care. Just ain't the deal to hawk underwear.
We're ball players and we're okay. Get in shape by opening day. Tasty leads, we'll be ready to play. Oh, ship your butts to double A. Yeah.
To build a Mercedes-Benz that's technologically innovative, safe, roomy, with exceptional handling is to be expected. But to do it for under $30,000, now that's a feat of engineering. Introducing the Mercedes-Benz C-Class.
Cincinnati, Ohio, 83,000 miles. Sandy Carlton, Atworth, Georgia, 98,000 miles. Jim Bobbitt, Broomall, Pennsylvania, 110,000 miles. We can't promise you the very same mileage these Michelin owners got. But we can promise you this, the very same peace of mind. Michelin.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Back at Rupp Arena, along with Al McGuire, this is Dick Stockton. Wake Forest leading Kansas by one.
Dick, King is put in there to commit a foul, neutralize the body of Ostertag.
Trying to alley-oop with Woodberry, too far under the basket. This is a quick passing team, that's why they have so many assists. 20 for the starting guards, Vaughn and Woodberry, the other day.
Watch King bump into Ostertag underneath there. He swung off him, now he has to get back on him.
10 on the shot clock. Cutting, Woodberry, he's got it. Woodberry now has 9 points of Kansas's 20. But Wake Forest, despite the fact they're in this ballgame, Childress has 5, but Owens hasn't scored. And they're going to need points from both Childress and Owens if they're going to stay in this thing.
Owens must contribute offensively. Has to drop one or two shots. He had a terrible shot and got away with the last game.
And they're going to call the foul against Wake Forest, the offensive foul.
Side on.
Second personal foul on Owens. Kansas with the ball leading by one. Right now, Kansas has 9 baskets and 9 assists. That's their style, but the lead is slim. There have been no free throws, Al, shot in the game yet by either team.
Let the guys play. You can always blow the whistle.
Vaughn and gold shirts underneath, taken down by Childress. Up ahead to Banks. Richie is guarding him on the man-to-man for the Jayhawks. Good deny by Woodberry. He's their best defender, and he's on Childress. He wants to cut him off.
Famous Kansas defense.
Harrison penetrating against the big guy. No-look pass and a foul. King has fouled going in. Fine no-look pass by Harrison inside. 6:26 remaining.
His first team six.
Right now, the shooting is down because of good defense on both sides. Kansas at 42, Wake at 38. Woodberry off to a good start with 9. Childress has 5 points, but they're going to need more from this junior from Clinton, Maryland, who has averaged 20 on the year.
be very difficult for King to make this. You have to do a lot of concentration.
Ostertag on the foul. King is a 39% free throw shooter.
I didn't want to say that.
Yeah, but he only went to the line 13 times during the
year. He's out there to neutralize the body of Ostertag. That's what he's there for.
And the first free throws of the game, King makes one out of two. So that's ahead of his average.
Watch them bump and grind, Ostertag and King underneath. They're banging underneath there. There it is.
He's the extra set of fouls they have with King so that Duncan and Owens don't get into foul trouble, and so far they haven't. Good touch pass back. Vaughn, a freshman from Pasadena, California. They go inside to Scott. Banks knocked it away off of Scott's hands. Good alert play by Scooter Banks, and Wake Forest can break the tie here with just under 6 minutes to go.
Wake Forest checking in is 21.
Got nice position underneath, but Banks comes over, gets a piece of the ball, and kicks it out. Touched the Jayhawk on the way out.
Kansas has turned it over seven times, so Wake is playing an outstanding defense. Tim Duncan has come in for King, so he's done his job, but we'll see more of him. Childress driving, offensive foul called against Childress, and that will be his second foul. Remember, the other day he played down the stretch with four personal fouls and never did foul out. He ended up scoring 14.
Dave Odom has no choice. He only has seven players out there, so if Childress gets in foul trouble early in this game, he'll still play down to the wire.
And both of Childress's fouls have been on the offensive end. Ostertag with Richie, Scott, Woodberry, and Vaughn.
The ball now to Ostertag. It should be 2 points.
Didn't kind of move for that, Al, too much, huh?
He doesn't have the quick feet, obviously.
Remember, he's taking, in case you don't know the story, he has exercise-induced asthma and taking medication to help his endurance.
And he plays 3-4 times as long this season as he did last season.
And he improved a big way. Here's Duncan, baseline. Tipped by Woodberry into the hands of Banks. Almost threw the ball off of the Jayhawk.
Three guards are spotted up.
Duncan. What a play! He looked it. He must have thought that Ostertag was 9-5.
Merry Christmas. That was a pigeon with a broken wing.
6 points for Duncan. He now becomes the high scorer for Wake Forest. Deacons lead by two with under 5 minutes remaining in the half. Their kind of game. Scott with a turnaround. Duncan with another rebound. He's got four. Duncan had 13 boards in round one, where Wake had to really struggle to win. Might have helped him, though, to play a tough game.
We got offense. Circle around the wagons.
Harrison. Ostertag clears. Kansas looking to tie at least. Each team with six fouls. Next one will be 1-1 on both sides. Richie hits another three. That's his second of the ball game. And Kansas has a 1-point lead.
Richie lulls you to sleep because I think he's somewhere around 6'8", isn't he, Dick? 6'9"?
Yes, Richie is 6'9", and a senior.
For Kansas,
and an offensive foul.
22, Randolph Childress.
Here's that loathsome dove up there with the broken wing. Watch this shot go in. You talk about an ugly shot going in, but they all count.
Turnover, not a foul. And massive substitutions again for Kansas. It's Pollard, Rayford, Williams, Gurley, and Pearson. Ordinarily, they would be all reserved. Pearson walked. No, he called for the offensive foul.
Both teams have committed six personal fouls. That one could be the seventh. Yes, it is the seventh, so we start 1-1. And one of the big things for Wake Forest is, remember this, they are excellent foul shooters. This guy here is truly automatic.
Foul was on Rayford, and Childress is on the line. 79% from the line. And Harrison goes out, replaced by LaRue. Childress has suffered a partial dislocated shoulder against North Carolina in the regular season before the ACC tournament. He was second to Grand Hill of Duke as the ACC player of the year. That's Woodberry getting last-minute instructions and now sitting down.
Very hard to knock out Wake Forest now. They had the opportunity early when the score was 6-0. Wake Forest hung in there. Should go down to the final 2-3 minutes.
Imagine a processor that's not just about more power. It's about an entirely new kind of PC. One that responds instantly to whatever you ask of it. One that breathes new life, a new spark into all your software. That's the power of the Pentium processor. From Intel, the computer inside.
He could have had the 60-foot sailboat, the house on the 18th green. But all Ned Crowley ever really wanted was a home on the range. At Dean Witter, our retirement plans are as individual as the people who dream.
We measure success one investor at a time.
Well, boys, how do you like the new backyard?
Who's got the winning color?
Three-point play could get you to the Final Four. Game cards inside specially marked cases of Pennzoil motor oil. Or will you get your oil changed professionally with Pennzoil? Scratch, match, and win one of four trips for two to the Final Four in 94 or 95. Or any of 10,000 other prizes. What a slam fest this is going to be. So fans, get your Pennzoil now and...
You got the winning color!
Oh man, what a game!
Hello.
So, what'd you think of that Bonneville? Did you drive it?
Oh, that SSEI is terrific.
Yeah.
Supercharged, traction control, ABS, dual airbags, leather. What a car.
I told you.
You're right. It's thousands less than the BMW or the Lexus.
Well?
I'm picking it up tomorrow. I owe you one, pal.
Okay. I'll take a white one.
They cross the line for love, but is there still a price to pay for breaking an old taboo? Love in Black and White, an all-new 48 Hours Wednesday.
Dick Stockton and Al McGuire under 4 minutes to go in the first half. Wake Forest shooting only 36%, yet they still have a one-point lead, and the reason may be 9 turnovers by Kansas to 11 points for Wake. This is the number 4 seed in a tight game against Wake Forest. Scott has the shot blocked inside by Duncan. And here comes Wake. They've got the ball in a one-point lead.
They have a tight ball game here because it's playing to the rhythm of the Demon Deacons.
It's a slow-up game to the delight of Dave Odom of Wake Forest. They don't have the numbers to go with Kansas. They go 10 men strong. Wake has about 7 or 8. And there is Childress leaving it over to Banks. And he's got it. Scooter Banks with the basket. Kansas scored the first 6 points of the ball game, and then Wake Forest came back with 7. Instead of being out of it early, they were in it early, and they're in it now.
And the unselfishness of Childress that time, spotting up.
Pearson missed the first shot, and Scott now is 6. He was the leading scorer with a career-high 26 against Tennessee Chattanooga in the first round. Driving the lane and getting the basket is Childress. He's got 9. He's the high scorer for Wake Forest.
Here's one of those water bugs, Rayford.
They go 10 deep, Rayford and... the outstanding speedy guards. Rayford coming off the bench. He's from Milwaukee.
This is the guy they want with the ball.
Triple team leaving Woodberry open, and a 3-second violation called against the Jayhawks.
Watch Randolph here. Works hard. Rubs off the pick. Got Rayford off the pick. He penetrates. Kicks out. Yes.
Also 10 turnovers by Kansas, and Roy Williams has to be perturbed because that's really what has kept Wake Forest not only in the game but in the lead right now. Charlie Harrison, starting guard, comes in for Rusty LaRue. Kansas also shooting only 39%. Keep in mind that only 2 teams this year shot better than 50% against Wake Forest's fine defense.
The Jayhawks have a problem when they're not scoring from downtown, outside.
Here's Palookas, one of the 3 guards that dot the Wake Forest lineup. Childress, nowhere to go.
Nice feed, good drop.
Open man, Banks. Wild shot. Kansas's half-court defense was as good as you get on that last sequence.
I get the ball in Woodbury's hands.
Vaughn trying to find somebody. He's got Ritchie. Missed the jumper, rebound, Blukas. Wake Forest leading by three. Their biggest lead has been four in the game with 1:40 to go. Watch the travel out to Harrison. Good passing on both sides. Good first step, Harrison. He's got the basket. Ooh. And Wake Forest has opened up its biggest lead.
No fear. And into the land of the big red trees.
Pollard, the big man, 6'11 freshman, and hitting from outside, Gurley misses. Blukas, boy, what a tiger he is this game compared to round one against Charleston.
Randolph, I believe, can take Woodbury in a one-on-one here.
Wake Forest is on an 8-2 run and controlling the tempo, just Al has pointed out they've got to do against the Jayhawks who like to transition game.
Because of the Jayhawks' depth.
Pick and roll, Duncan. More like a pick and spot up. Duncan missed the open shot. Here's Woodbury with now 40 seconds and running. Ritchie for three. Pollard, and they may call it on Duncan. Let's see.
I think you're on the money, Dick.
For Dickin, that's Duncan, that's his first foul. But I remind you, coming up at our Pennzoil at the half, Jim Nance and Clark Kellogg with tournament scores and highlights. In our first game here, Purdue defeated Alabama 83-73, and the big dog, Glenn Robinson, scored 33 points.
Gave us all a very interesting show.
Ow! Howling in the night.
That sounds like a wolf, doesn't it?
Yeah. And that big dog will be howling in Knoxville against the winner of this game. Kansas with its first free throw attempts. Pollard makes good on the first. Dave Odom told us yesterday that he once tried to hire Roy Williams as his assistant when he was coaching at East Carolina. One out of two for Pollard. Duncan gets the rebound. 4-point lead for Wake Forest, and they can play for the last shot.
They'll take it down for one shot. This is about a 3-second spread. They'd be tickled pink to get in four down.
Wake's playing a smart game.
It's a chess game.
LaRue, Blukas, they're not letting them get the three so much. Duncan down low with a turnaround. Good block. That was Pollard, the freshman out of San Diego, California, with the block. And now, with 1 second, Vaughn puts it up, and it nearly wins. And that is the end of the first half. Wake Forest 30 and Kansas 26. Back with the Pennzoil at the half with Jim Nance and Clark Kellogg.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Pontiac, Dean Witter, and by Intel.
This is the sports car no one could match. Not Acura, not Mazda, not even Porsche could answer our challenge to match Firebird's standard driver and passenger airbags, standard anti-lock brakes, and 275 horsepower engine for even twice the price of this new Firebird formula. Soon other sports cars will try to close the distance, and that's okay, but that will be then. This new Firebird is now.
College can be a bridge to the future. It's a place where you're free to express yourself, a time to find out what you're really capable of. But when testing your limits involves alcohol, when breaking away includes drinking and driving, when expressing yourself includes losing control, the lessons you learn in college may not help you get anywhere at all.
This is CBS.
I'm Tom Blackburn of Blackburn and Green. Some things in life never change. You can depend on them. At Blackburn and Green, we work hard to make sure you receive full compensation for your personal injury claim. There's never an attorney fee until we make a recovery for you. You can depend on it. That will never change.
A message from Blackburn and Green,
attorneys for injured people.
Now let me get this straight. You want a great deal on a new car, and you're considering a Pontiac Grand Am or a Nissan Altima? You do want air conditioning, right? Well, no problem on this Grand Am, but it costs a lot more on the Altima. Automatic transmission? It's included in the Grand Am's price. And you want anti-lock brakes. That's a biggie for the import. So you want all that, and you're considering the Altima? I thought you wanted a great deal.
Grand Am. Just $199 a month buys it with a 3-year smart drive. See your Greater Fort Wayne Pontiac dealers now.
Wake Forest leading Kansas 30-26, and when we come back, we'll have Jim Nance and Clark Kellogg, Pennzoil at the half from our New York studios.
Hey, Terry Lucas!
Not now!
Oh, that's got to be your new Grand Am V6 over there!
I love my Grand Am!
Sporty fun, it's you, Terry!
Not so fast! My Pontiac Grand Am's got standard anti-lock brakes!
Really?
Airbag, leather,
yeah.
All kinds of stuff!
So fun, had nothing to do with it?
Don't jump to conclusions!
NAPA, we're the most complete source for auto parts, and all NAPA parts are backed by a nationwide warranty program. No wonder more Americans trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
To play this game, you gotta have the love. But most importantly...
Hey, man, you got the ball?
No, I ain't got the ball. You got it? Say what?
You gotta have the ball. The all-new Street Ball. It's a Rawlings. It's only $4.99 and only at Pizza Hut.
Hey, Chubbs. Want a game?
From Red Grange to the modern grace of Olympian Tracy Corbin, the flavor and pageantry of all 21 men's and women's collegiate sports come alive at the NCAA Visitor Center. Come celebrate the magic moments in college sports at the NCAA Visitor Center, open year-round in Kansas City.
Be there again and again. Relive March Madness with the official 1994 NCAA Championship video by calling 1-800-747-7999. It's all here, from the excitement of the opening rounds to the drama of the Final Four. That's 1-800-747-7999 to get your official copy of the 1994 NCAA Championship video.
Wednesday, a kid problem you won't believe.
Whoever's IQ test came back today, it turns out that your son has a superior mind.
It's a pretty sick joke, lady.
All new time Wednesday.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
Welcome back to New York. Pennzoil at the Half. You got the playbook right
here. Yeah, the Malik Sealy custom-made playbook tie in the red and tan look.
Actually has the plays design right there on you. Sure. How about this game we're watching here at halftime with Wake up in front by 4, 30-26. You really jazz the way they're playing.
Oh, yeah, I like the way they're playing. We've got some great games going on. I mean, they're well officiated, but Wake does it with the perimeter play. Randolph Childress has 9 points. Mark Blukas is playing well. They shoot the threes, and as long as it's tight, I think Wake has an excellent chance to win.
You like the way this game's being officiated. George Washington trailing UConn by 3. They're just a couple of minutes away from starting the second half. And what's the story in this game here? Because UConn started out with the game's first 10 points.
Well, what happened was UConn got out because they were able to get into transition. Then all of a sudden they go to a zone defense, and they kind of put the parking brake on. They were driving the car with the parking brake on, and that allowed George Washington to get back in the game, largely in part due to Yinka Dare.
But they're letting them play. Dare has 11 points, 4 dunks in that game, and GW's come from behind to now trail by only 3. The one final today, Purdue over Alabama. A 10-point win. Boilermakers, the first team to make it into the Sweet 16. And if you missed it, Glenn Robinson, 33 points and 11 rebounds. A nice game also by Jamal Faulkner of Alabama. He had 25 and 11 rebounds in a losing cause. But Purdue advances on to Knoxville and the regionals. And we're getting set now. UConn and George Washington, they're on the floor now for the second half. So let's go out to Long Island with James Brown and Billy Packer with the call. Let's look in.
Want
it's a much better ball game than it started out. 35-30, Connecticut, the number two seed, leading George Washington, the 10th seed. The two marquee players have led the way. Yinka Daray with 11 powerful points, slamming his way to that. And Danielle Marshall with 11 for Connecticut.
And how about this? Full court man-to-man. The way Connecticut started, aggressive man-to-man, got it into a running game. Then they went into zone, and that put GW into a half-court game, which they played extremely well.
And you were surprised that Connecticut went to the zone.
Pass too low, down around Daray's ankle.
This is Daron Sheffer ahead to Danielle Marshall. Danielle admitted to being nervous in the first game on Thursday. Swipe from behind. Marcus Ford has the credit. Pearsall has the ball. Can't get the drop. And Nimbo Hammond. Boy, I tell you, when Nimbo Hammond sits down to look at the tape, Billy, he could have about 30 points already.
Yeah, he's working, JB. And there we see our brackets out here. Penn and Florida coming up.
Speaking of Penn and Florida coming up, Billy, the best team on Thursday night of the eight here.
Well, it was
University
Penn,
of Pennsylvania,
without question. And I don't think that that was any upset the way they played. They came out in every phase of the game. They were outstanding.
Great, outstanding defensive play that time by Danielle. Those long arms working to benefit.
Exactly. They came out, you know, from behind Jones. He couldn't believe that the arm stretched that far.
You know what? You were more accurate. You said he does. He, being Danielle, reminds you of Connie Hawkins, and that's right.
Yep.
More so than Julius.
For younger people out there, they probably say, well, who was Connie Hawkins? But he was before Dr. J, and he had that kind of play that you just saw Danielle make. Way before his time, one of the all-time greats.
Off the knee of Daron Sheffer, it goes over to GW. And Connie handled the ball like it was a tennis ball and had great games against the likes of a Will Chamberlain.
Exactly. Considered still, I guess, along with Kareem, the greatest player ever to come out of New York City. Hall of Famer now, and certainly deserving.
And you saw that graphic, Yinka Daray carrying the load for George Washington, which trails Connecticut 36-30, 18-13 left in the ball game. The two-seed Connecticut against the 10-seed GW. Butler advances to the Sweet 16.
By keeping that ball alive with his dribble, Pearsall eliminates the double team. And what Sheffer was trying to do is to guide him into the sideline, have the sideline and the teammate, in effect, to create a triple team on him. But nice job by Pearsall by going back.
Daray before the shot. And Billy, a little thing, but I talk about the way that Daray collects himself when he gets the ball. That adds to his strength.
Yeah, you know, he really has nice balance in his upper part of his body. He obviously needs footwork, but notice his upper part. He really does collect himself there, but see, his footwork really isn't as good as it should be. They're most of the times a little bit too close together.
I was about to say, wasn't spaced nice.
Right. But, you know, he's only played 5 years of basketball, so, you know, a lot to learn.
He's doing all right for a five-year player. Yeah, that was a little too high a pass intended for Daray.
And the spacing not there. You know, you're throwing the ball into the postman, and you're separated by about 20 feet. That's too far.
GW had done a better job of protecting the ball the second half of the first half, but not so this point in the game, Billy.
Yeah, three turnovers already here in the second half. Hammond's down low with Danielle Marshall. Problem.
Of Daray in the first half comes back with his own first basket of the ball game for Hayward.
Back into his zone, 2-3.
Hammond loses the handle but stays GW ball. 17 on the shot clock. Under 10 on the shot clock. Hammond. Blocking foul called on Hayward.
A case where just good upper body strength by Nimbo allowed him to draw that foul. A lesser built guy would have fallen to the side.
Third personal on Hayward, and he'll have to come out of the ball game. Travis Knight, the 7-footer, comes in to replace Hayward. Travis Knight really has some pretty nice potential, Billy. He definitely has the ability to grow more as a player.
But when you think about Connecticut making a push to win a national championship, and we mentioned how a dominating center hasn't won since Patrick Ewing back in 84, but what teams have had that have won it is a center position that can negate the big man. Now, in the case of Connecticut, they do it by committee.
Mm-hmm.
Three different guys, 15 fouls, and they all get about the same amount of playing time and produce about the same.
And each player bringing a different set of skills to the table. Rudy Johnson over tonight. Knight hammered by Kwame Evans. First personal on Evans. Second team foul this half on GW.
There was a case when Vaughn Jones had to realize that Johnson is not going to put up the shot. He's going to penetrate. So he went out a little bit too aggressively. Johnson broke by him. That's what scouting reports are all about, you know?
Now Travis Knight will shoot one more for Coach Jim Calhoun, who 12 years ago on this floor lost in triple overtime. He was the coach at Northeastern that day, lost in triple OT at the Nassau Coliseum in a game against Villanova and Rolly Massimino. But who is dictating the tempo here in this game, would you say?
Well, right now, I think they're jockeying for tempo. Again, George Washington would like to establish the big fella. UConn is mixing their defense, playing a little zone to try to keep it out of his hands. And I think we're going to have to see in the next 4 or 5 minutes who exactly is able to establish the way they want to play down the stretch.
All right, we'll keep everybody up to date on that game. We're in part two of quadruple header Saturday, so stay with us on the road to the Final Four. Thanks for joining us right here on the Pennzoil at the Half.
Pennzoil at the Half was sponsored by Pennzoil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
We designed a new car. We created a new class. We developed new engineering. We created a new standard of performance. We redefined value. Introducing the Mercedes-Benz C-Class. It wasn't designed to compete with other cars. It was designed to replace them. The new C-Class, starting at under $30,000.
They were four sisters unable to live normal lives.
Don't touch me.
Their only hope for sanity.
I'm starting to remember things in my childhood.
Was to face their past and expose the truth.
You're talking about publicly suing Dad.
My dad did unspeakable things to us.
Starring Marlo Thomas, Mel Harris, and Ally Sheedy. Sisters who triumphed against impossible odds.
This is about holding our father accountable for what he did.
Ultimate Betrayal, Sunday. Due to mature theme, parental discretion is advised.
This is CBS.
Hey, Jim. New windows?
Looks great, huh?
Pella windows?
Nah.
Didn't you go to the Pella window store?
Who needs them?
They got Pella certified contractors for that.
Who needs them either?
And they would have helped you with that, too.
Oh, yeah.
Pella would have helped you pick out the right sizes.
Yeah, right.
Pella? What is that number?
Kelly Chevrolet invites you to a spring blowout.
March 24th, 25th, and 26th.
An event so big it could only be held at the Memorial Coliseum. Northeast Indiana has never had a selection of new and used vehicles like this before. Incredible deals.
Incredible financing.
Incredible leasing. Cars, trucks, vans, and conversion vans.
Listen carefully. This is the buying opportunity of 1994.
Kelly Chevrolet's Spring Blowout.
March 24th through 26th.
The Coliseum.
Wake Forest leading Kansas 30-26, and that ties for Kansas' second lowest first half point total this season. And Al McGuire, as you pointed out, the pace, despite the depth, has really paid off for Wake Forest.
It's paid off for Wake Forest, but Wake Forest has one problem. It must get some offensive scoring out of Tre Owens. Has to get something out of the tree.
He's 0 for 5 and hasn't scored, so that's the second game struggling in the tournament. Kansas held to 34% shooting. Both teams are under 40. Kansas has turned it over 10 times, 5 more than Wake, and that has hurt them. Both teams have substituted. Nothing surprising with Kansas, but it looks like Dave Odom has also shuttled in his smaller bench a great deal. And the leading scorers, the ones we focused at the top, Childress and Woodberry, the two guards each with 9 points. It'll be Wake Forest ball. It'll be Blucas, Harrison, and Childress in the backcourt. Up front, it's Owens and Duncan. Scott, Pearson, Vaughn, Ostertag, and Woodberry in the white-shirted Kansas uniform.
Jayhawks come out man-to-man.
Shot put up by Owens. Still struggling, 0 for 6 now. Duncan, however, converts. Duncan having a fine game. Member of freshman, 8 points, and the biggest lead of the game for Wake Forest. Ostertag gets inside, and that drops. Ostertag with his second field goal of the game.
They get the ball into Ostertag. There's no way that Duncan can even put a body on him.
Inside. That is Trelawney Owens. Sooner or later. And it was a big one with his one field goal against Charleston. Hits his first basket here to give Wake a 6-point lead. The winner here will face Purdue as Pearson is called for the offensive foul. And it's Scott, not Pearson. Two fouls on Scott. You know, it's interesting that Vaughn and Rayford, the Jayhawks point guards, have not scored and have two assists between them. Those were big worries for Dave Odom as far as the transition game is concerned. Hasn't been there today for Kansas. Owens, can he hit two in a row? Misses Ostertag, the rebound.
What the tree has to realize is his scoring range is about 10 feet in. If you take a shot about 15 feet up, that's outside his range. Poor shot selection.
Well, maybe trying to force a little bit here. Pearson with the jumper. Remember, he started this game, second straight turning game, and he gets his first points of the contest. Batted out of bounds by Vaughn. Wake Forest with a lot of time and a 4-point lead. Wake is the number 5 seed, and Kansas seeded number 4.
Kansas earlier in the season won the preseason NIT in the Big Apple.
Beat Indiana in the process. Blucas, instead of a shot, goes to Duncan. Great move by Blucas. Kansas thought he was going to put it up.
That's what I told you in the first half. He's getting shots blocked against the big guy. Gets a big guy like that, you got to dunk. Otherwise, Ostertag can put it right back in your face.
Duncan now with 10 points, double figures, and coming in, getting the hoop is Scott. So Richard Scott with a career-high 26 against UTC. He's gotten to go now.
Watch Timmy Duncan down low here. Rather than just trying to block it, he goes in and dunks it, which eliminates Ostertag. On this side down here, what Scott is doing down here, he's using his physical strength.
And the foul is on Trelawney Owens, who has committed his third personal foul. He's the only player in the, on either side with 3 fouls. So that's going to cause some problems for Odom. We may see more of Stan King, who used his body in action during the first half. Scott, 47% free throw shooter. Looked like an 80 the way he shot that one.
Well, he isn't playing with the brace on for a number of games this year. He had the brace on that bad shoulder. 1-3-1.
3-point lead weight.
Double the corners. Weak side. Corner will be open.
New clock on a kickball by Scott. Mentioned the preseason NIT. Kansas won 16 of its first 17. And then when Scott came down with an injury, lost 5 of their next 10 games. And then they finished hot. They had that one slump in the middle.
When they have a problem is when they're not hitting from outside. Corners are open.
Missing in the corner is Trelawney Owens, and the bad pass, outlet pass by Pearson. No one was down court. Another turnover for Kansas.
Tree, I think you should be driving underneath. That's not your range. Solid defense by the Jayhawks.
Ostertag moved out on top. Now Duncan looking for the ball inside. Childress for 3. Duncan gets the rebound.
Round the horn again. You got a new clock, Timmy.
He's up a lot in weight, but he's handled himself well. Here's Harrison missing, and the foul the other way against Duncan. Maybe Duncan's second foul, and it is, with 3 minutes exactly gone by.
Fouling on Duncan, his second.
Pollard, low scoring game, Dan.
Yeah, I was going to say Pollard coming in, and Ostertag going out. You can make a film of all the substitutions, and it would take you 2 hours just showing them going and coming.
They're still automatic almost, especially for the big man, because Duncan has a problem, not Duncan, Ostertag has a problem with his endurance.
Yep, the asthma problem that He's taken a drug that has alleviated a lot of that this year, and his game raised it a level. He's their top rebounder. But Pollard in there right now. 3-point lead for Wake Forest. We've been stuck on 36-33 for a couple of minutes now. Scot Pollard follows. Pollard at 17 points and 6 rebounds in 20 minutes. Member of the All-Big 8 freshman team. Kansas has missed just one shot so far in this half, and they trail by a point.
That's one of the few times Wake Forest has got to box out.
Childress going inside, and
Randolph is saying it was my fault. Tried to get too much done. He killed his dribble too soon.
Turnover. Kansas has doubled Wake Forest, but that traveling call, Wake Forest has taken advantage. An 11-point edge in the turnover ratio. Nearly 4 minutes gone by, second half. Wake leads by one.
Richie'd like to get one from cannon range.
Woodberry against Childress. 9 on the shot clock now. Rayford, and Vaughn that is, setting it up. Vaughn will fire a 3 from up top. Wild shot. Scot trying to save, out of bounds, and it's Wake Forest ball. Vaughn, point guard, is 0-for-5 from the field.
Timeout on the floor.
The women's Final Four coming soon on CBS.
Like a rock.
Here's the Chevy S series in color. Here it is in black and white. The new Chevy S series. Everything else is history.
Well, as I was saying, I'll bring the cold drafts, and you just bring those beautiful eyes of yours.
Yeah. Could you hold on?
When cold filtered is cool enough.
Hi, it's your shot.
Ice draft.
I've got to go.
Susan?
It's ice brewed below freezing, then cold filtered. For a smoother, better draft, taste the future. Ice draft. Only from Budweiser.
What happened?
Chevy, in a minute, we gotta talk. You're canceled.
How do you get canceled out of a commercial?
You're not getting the ratings, Chevy.
I like this stuff.
Well, keep the bag, Chev.
Oh, you're a sport, Chevy. You look great.
Tough year. Good chip.
Doritos, tortilla thins. Everything else is just a chip.
Monday, Clint Eastwood returns in his most famous role, Dirty Harry.
Go ahead.
Sudden impact.
Make my day.
Contains some violent scenes. And on Tuesday, he's tired of the crime. And when they come after his family,
then he'd kill us both.
He's tired of playing by the rules. Steven Seagal, Marked for Death, contains some violent scenes.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by the new Chevy S Series, new ice brewed ice draft, and by Doritos Tortilla Thins.
Back here at Rupp Arena, a few moments ago, Wake Forest established their biggest lead of 36-30. Kansas has run off 5 in a row. Back in the game, trailing by 1. Harrison and Childress with Owens. Back in the game with Banks and Blukas. Here is Blukas hitting a 3. He's come out today. 2 3-point baskets. Vaughn. Richie in there along with Pollard. Scot. And Woodberry. He's got it now. Open is Vaughn. And he hits it. Boy, that's one of the rare shots from outside. Vaughn and their point guards have struggled today. Those are the first points for the point guards today. and Vaughn with the three. So that's the total of the Kansas point guards, only two assists and 3 points, one basket made.
Vaughn does not want to shoot from out there, but he was so open he had to.
Owens backing in against Pollard, looked like he might have walked. Pollard the rebound to Vaughn. Wake by one, Kansas can take the lead. Owens still struggling, 1 for 10 from the field. Amazing that Wake is in front. Scott comes in and is fouled, and Scott will go to the line, and that'll be the 13th foul of the second half by the Demon Deacons.
His first team third. Coming in for Kansas,
Scott is extremely strong. Watch, you get the guy in his hip there, he has inside position, he seals, goes up and goes to the foul line.
Foul is on Scooter Banks. Ostertag back in and Duncan back in for their respective teams. And here is Scott, again struggling, 47% free throw shooter this year. But he has hit his only one from the line in the game.
He's an overachiever. He has surprising quickness, especially down low against bigger men.
That's Rusty LaRue. And Harrison gets a breather. Minutes gone by here in the second half. The winner of this Wake Forest Kansas game here at Rupp Arena will move on to Knoxville in the Sweet 16 and a date with the top-seeded Purdue Boilermakers. Their big star Glenn Robinson scored 33 points today in a 10-point victory over Alabama.
We need a basket now from the three guards.
Kansas regains the lead. Here is LaRue. He doesn't waste much time before putting it up. That's why he's in there. Lucas is on Woodberry.
Scott give a high pick. There it is.
A good one. And Woodberry hits. The three-point basket. His second of the game by Woodberry. He's got 12 now. And here comes Kansas getting the ball back. They're on a 13-3 run. Jayhawks establishing themselves again. Vaughn goes up without the ball. And here's Childress bringing it up for the gold-shirted Deacons. Low to Owens. Struggling, 1 for 11, but here's Duncan, and he cleans up. What a great game by Duncan, considering that Owens is struggling.
What he did that time is nice back move. He was under the basket and gave himself some room by moving back.
12 points and 9 boards for the freshman from St. Croix in the Virgin Islands. And another turnover. Richie tried to get it to Scott. That's Richie. Normally a starter, did not begin the game because of the hip problem. Here is the freshman who you'll be hearing a lot about in the future, B.J. Williams, who had a career-high 13 points in the first round.
B.J.'s going to be around, and everybody will know about him as the years go by.
Richie won't let Lucas get the shot off. Kansas smothering the three possibilities. Duncan, give and go, rarely see it. Loose ball. Possession arrow will go the other way, so it'll be Kansas ball. Gurley will come in for the Jayhawks. And going out will be Richie.
Kind of an ugly game, but it's the game that Wake Forest wants. They just want a slow game. It might get a little bit away from them here. They could use a stopper right now, and that's early to say, but Wake just wants to stay close to the last 3 minutes and maybe steal it.
They're up by 6 early here in the second half, but Kansas came back to regain the lead. Jayhawks by 2 right now, advancing to the second round for the 11th consecutive year. Nine on the shot clock. They got Woodberry going right around LaRue. Couple of tips miss, and again Duncan with the rebound, and that is his 10th of the game. Tim Duncan, who had 13 rebounds in round one, 10 more right now. LaRue gets it in low to Duncan. Foul, basket good. Ostertag was on him, and Tim Duncan has been the big hero for the Demon Deacons today.
Maybe they're not broken wing shots. They look like they're broken wing to me, but they go in and they're all net. Now don't forget, this guy's approximately 7'2" that he's shooting against. So let's take another angle of it. It just doesn't look like a good shot, but he's draining them.
And the game is tied at 43. Pollard will come in for Ostertag, who goes out with two fouls. And Tim Duncan will be on the line. Remember that he was discovered in the Virgin Islands when Chris King, former member of the Wake Forest Deacons, went on an NBA postseason tour and found him in an open outdoor court. And Duncan had several teams that he looked at, including Delaware. You know, he almost went to Delaware State, oddly enough. He came down to four schools and ultimately went with Wake.
Is Delaware State, they the fighting blue hands, or that's University
of Delaware? That's Delaware. Delaware. I don't know what the Staters are.
That's going up.
And missed by LaRue. Rebound by Gurley. High score. Nearly 8 minutes elapsed here in the second half. LaRue guarding inside against Woodberry, and the foul for Kansas. They'll go to the line. Wake Forest with team foul number four.
One thing that Wake Forest can't do is get their big man in foul trouble. They got no backups. You got this guy King that they bring off the bench. He averages about 1.2 a game. He's out there to neutralize strength and also to give fouls. But there's no reserves on the baseline for Wake Forest.
And right now, Al, Dave Odom does have his big men with foul trouble because Owens has three, and now Duncan has picked up his third personal foul. So they're right on the tightrope right there as far as that's concerned as Woodberry hits the first free throw.
Well, then look for them more to get ticks off the clock to shorten the game.
Roy Williams with the chalkboard.
Sounds like one of those chants from Allen Fieldhouse.
Rock Chalk Jayhawk. Woodberry has 14 points and 6 assists. He hasn't turned it over today.
From Gillette comes a revolutionary form of antiperspirant protection. Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. Because it's a clear, clean, powerful gel, it goes on smoothly with no white residue to form an invisible barrier of protection. All-day protection against both wetness and odor. Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. One of the advanced deodorants and antiperspirants in the Gillette series.
They speak it in England, France, and Germany. It sounds the same in the U.S. and Mexico as it does in Hong Kong and Tokyo. It's the international language of business. And wherever it's spoken, Delta Airlines can put you right in the middle of the conversation. And then we'll bring you back to that place where you don't have to say a word to be understood.
Jockey. Real quality. Real fit. No wonder guys feel comfortable with Jockey.
Genuine Jockey! Yeah.
Before introduction, a Moen faucet is tested at least 500,000 times against leaks and drips. So it's hard to find a more reliable faucet. No matter how you look at it. Moen. Buy it for looks. Buy it for life.
Motor Trend magazine said my Prism reminded them of the $30,000 import sedan class.
Car and driver described my Geo Prism as lovely lines, Lexus refinement.
An automobile magazine called my Prism the new wonder of the automotive world.
Before you buy your next car, call 1-800-GET-TO-KNOW and get to know Geo Prism.
Broden Track said run, don't walk to your Geo dealer. So that's what I did.
A swimming party ends in tragedy. But was it an accidental drowning or a lover's revenge?
Hands off and step back.
In the heat of the night, Wednesday.
Dick Stockton and Al McGuire back here at Rupp Arena. Second round action in the Southeast Region in Lexington. Kansas leading by 2 points. Childress scored 9 points, but has yet to score in the second half. Woodberry, the top point man for Kansas with 14. Maybe time for Randolph to go to work, Al. What do you think?
He has to start thinking the star mentality. You got to remember that Randolph was first team ACC.
And averaged 20 points a game. Lucas, Childress, and Harrison in there. And up front, it's Trelawney Owens and Duncan. Owens really having a miserable tournament, just 2-for-20 in the two games. Here's Harrison with a jump shot. Two-point shot, and we're tied at 45. Pollard inside, has it blocked inside. I think it was Duncan with help from Lucas.
Harrison's Lexington scored an important time yesterday. Her last basket was big time today.
And Duncan playing with three personal fouls, as is Owens. Trying to force a pass inside was Childress. And now here is Vaughn. Both shirts are back defensively. Open man is Gurley. He can hit the three, and he does. Great Gurley.
That's what he's out there for.
Kansas by a trade. Knocked away by Vaughn. It is still Wake ball with 29 seconds. And if you think Vaughn's quick enough, you're going to see a quicker one in Calvin Rafer, the 5'7 junior from Milwaukee, coming in the game. He's the quickest point guard. And Rafer had 5 assists coming off the bench in the win against UTC.
Woodberry has to be taken out. He's tired. He wanted the blow. You've got to start with that star mentality, Childress. You want to keep your team in the game now.
That was
time for you to start. The stars. Time for you to start putting them up.
Sure is. Pearson replaced Woodberry. Childress scoreless this half. Has 9 points.
Comes around the horn. There it is.
3-point shot. A brick. Duncan. Foul. I tell you, without Tim Duncan in this game, Wake Forest would be packing their bags for Winston-Salem.
His first team third.
He's only played organized basketball for 3 years.
Amazing. And you know the thing that Dave Odom said about him, he says, you know, he has no bad habits. He said the two things that Tim Duncan did without any teaching is he didn't dribble the ball and he knew how to block a shot.
Also, when you come from outside the continental United States, you always can play soccer. You played it when you were young. So the tall guys from outside the United States, they have eye-foot coordination, where all the American athletes have eye-hand coordination.
Hakeem Olajuwon.
Patrick Ewing.
Right.
They have lateral movement.
Duncan now with 16 points, 11 rebounds, and has blocked 3 shots. Kansas lead cut to 1. Nearly halfway through the second half. Winner gets Purdue at Knoxville next week. Pearson slicing in nicely. Everything but the hoop. Duncan with another rebound, and that's his 12th. Owens from the baseline. Can't do a thing offensively. Rebound Pollard. And the foul will traveling called against Rayford. And it was Childress who helped out the official.
Helped him out in a major league way. He looked over at the official, gave him the sign, and the hesitation. Now, he did walk, but it looked like that he called the violation rather than the official.
So, Wake Forest trailing by 1 point in the ball. Pollard. And a turnover against Wake Forest. Long pass to make inside to a big man that's not high enough.
Rayford, they lay off him. He will not take the outside shot.
Scot, they need the points from Scot. Woodberry as well. And Harrison is fouled by Pearson inside, and that'll be the 14th foul against the Jayhawks and 2 against Pearson.
There's also 4 fouls against Wake.
Kansas checking in number.
Well, here's the story with Wake Forest. They're in the game despite the fact that that man is only 1 for 12 today and 2 points. Remember, he came in averaging over 15, and Childress has not scored this half.
Well, Tree is supposed to score within 3 feet of the rim. You can't score within 3 feet of the rim if you're 18 feet out. He has to get down low.
Here's Childress. Starts to get going. That's his first points of the second half. Wake Forest leading by 1. Will they spring the upset? And it would be, because Kansas is the favorite in this game, was a 4 seed.
Woodberry has to be stopped.
Woodberry has 14 in the game. Pollard the basket and the foul. And if it's on Duncan, and it is, it'll be 4 on Tim.
I think it might have taken Tim out for about 2 minutes, Coach Dave. You got to move in King. Let him commit a foul or 2. He didn't want to put his hand in on this play. But young Tim, he's only 17 years of age, put his hand in, committed the foul, and Pollard finalized.
And Odom, reading your mind. They're going to bring Banks in, not King. There's the foul. Duncan goes out. He has scored 16 points and has 12 rebounds.
He'll shoot 1.
father can play over Banks' head.
Pollard with the three-point play to give Kansas a two-point lead. This has been a tight game throughout. Even though Kansas scored the first six, Wake came back with seven, and it's been a nail-biter ever since.
Guards have to move. Spot up on the weak side.
Trying to beat you off the dribble. Harrison way off the mark. Throws up the air ball for three. In three-point territory.
I thought that time that Curley got a piece of that ball on the way up.
Jacques Vaughn, who had a career-high 11 assists against Tennessee Chattanooga in the first round. Here is Woodberry. And it goes. Smart. Kansas didn't interfere with it up on the cylinder.
Good second thought by Williams, the freshman. Almost touched the ball.
Woodberry 6 of 9 from the field. He's got 16. He and Duncan are the game-high scorers. Childress leaves it off for Banks. Nothing doing. In and out by Childress. Gurley for Kansas. 4-point Jayhawk lead. Plenty of time remaining.
Big score this time down for the Jayhawks.
Pollard, the double. Leave Vaughn open for three. Loose ball. Vaughn again. New clock.
Coach Williams wants a set. See him over there. He wants a set. He's going to set play. I would think it would feed Pollard down low if possible. There it is. Didn't get it in. There it is again. Over the top. Get it into Pollard. Over the top. Too late now. The clock's effective.
Open. Three-point attempt. Vaughn. Missed the shot. Here's Pollard. And the basket's going to count. And the foul. Kansas had too much off the board. They had too many chances at the hoop, and they took advantage of it, and now they lead by six, which matches their biggest lead to start the game.
And no one can cover Pollard down low if he gets the ball.
They're going to have to bring Duncan back right now.
Here's a shot off the rim, dancing around. Pollard comes up and gives that baby hook, dances around, automatic down.
Lucas with the personal foul, his second, and the 16 foul against Wake Forest. Tim Duncan has to come back in the game now because Kansas is up by six, even though he's got four personal fouls. So here's a freshman going against an experienced Kansas team. One more foul and they lose their big man.
Most likely Wake to go to a zone to protect the freshman inside the zone defensively.
The Women's Final Four coming soon on CBS.
This is the award-winning Goodyear Aqua Tread with its deep groove aqua channel. And this is the new Eagle Aqua Tread for performance sedans. A wider performance tire with two aqua channels to sweep water away. Now you get the wet traction of a Goodyear Aqua Tread and the performance of a Goodyear Eagle. One good turn deserves another. The new Eagle Aqua Tread, only from Goodyear. We say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
Is the planet Earth. And this is the most popular line of sport utility vehicles on the planet. Chevrolet.
If you're a GTE telephone customer...
Hello, GTE Customer Care Center.
I have a question.
This is what service looks like.
We'll take care of it right away.
Because at GTE Customer Care Centers all across the country...
One second, I can fix it from here.
Our employees have the power to solve customer needs on the spot.
I can do that right now.
Are you sure you don't have to ask your supervisor?
Yes, ma'am, I'm sure.
Customer Care Centers from GTE help us serve our telephone customers faster. Another way, it's amazing what we can do together.
Dear car owners, if you had a brake problem tomorrow, could you think of one brake specialist to go to? Where can you go for same-day brake service? A guarantee on brake shoes and pads for as long as you own your car. And the expertise of doing over 2 million brake jobs a year? Midas.
Think of us as the brake specialists. We're pretty good at mufflers, too.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
All right, Jim Nance and Clark Kellogg back in New York. I know then more than just a couple of you interested in this game with UConn and George Washington in the East. A rare four-point play a moment ago by Ray Allen. Knocked out a three, was fouled, hit the free throw. Puts the Huskies up 12, but GW at the line, Clark.
GW is in the blinking yellow light zone. They must proceed with caution and at the same time reckless abandon shooting the threes. UConn has been able to put together a little spurt to get it to 12 points.
Donnell Marshall has really not been the star player in this tournament that we had seen during the regular season.
Well, I think part of it is due to the fact that George Washington is so physical inside. Donnell's still not as strong as he needs to be to be a factor in a physical half-court type of game.
So it's a 10-point lead, 3.5 to go. Let's send it back now. Wake missed at the other end. Back to Dickinow.
Jim Calhoun has a turn nice among the top. Nice move, good pass over with a big three-point hoop. And the Jayhawks on an 11-0 run have opened up a 10-point lead over Wake Forest, which led by 4 at the half and 6 early in the second half. And here's another turnover. Dick Stockton and Al McGuire here at Rupp Arena. The winner will move on to play Purdue in Knoxville in the Sweet 16 next week in Tennessee.
Spread it out. Get it down low to Ostertag. Ostertag set the pick up high. Now he's going down low. Got to remember, Duncan has 4 fouls. He can't play him, but down low, Ostertag.
Duncan has been a savior.
There it is.
For Wake with 16 points and 12 rebounds. Didn't have control of it. Vaughn, and here comes LaRue, who's in the backcourt along with Childress and Harrison up front. It's Trelawney Owens and Duncan playing with the 4.
Need a cannon shot right about now. Get back in this ball game. Here it comes. Ooh, let it go by.
Harrison misses the 2, kept alive. Good play by Owens. Childress up top. He misses the 3. Duncan gets the rebound. They'll go out again. Nearly 5 minutes to play. Childress going up. And Harrison not able to save that one as he dives into the press row. Childress 1-for-7 this half. He scored 9 points to lead the team at halftime and has grown ice cold. So Owens and Childress are not giving Wake Forest their offensive production right now.
One of the biggest problems for Wake Forest has been the shot selection from 3 Owens.
11-0 run for the Jayhawks in the last 5.5 minutes, and we have under 5 minutes remaining in the game. Pollard with 2 big 3-point plays. Back in the lineup now for Kansas. Vaughn missed the 3. Pollard with the rebound, and it doesn't go for it. But the Jayhawks continue to pound the glass. That was the worst fear for Dave Odom, the offensive rebounding of Kansas.
New clock, they gave a few ticks. That was a big turnover. He takes it himself. On the way!
Ooh. And Pollard commits the foul, and that'll be the 15th foul against Kansas. Wake Forest has 6. Next foul will be 1-1.
I don't know if it's Randolph's left arm that's hurting or left wrist. See how he holds it? It's tight to him. Something's hurting him. I don't know which part of the arm.
Wake Forest took a 1-point lead on Childress's only field goal in this half. And then Pollard at 2 3-point plays. Woodberry a field goal. Jacques Vaughn a 3. And Kansas opened up a 10-point lead. Childress missing the first free throw.
Will not move his left arm.
1 out of 2. 9-point lead for the Jayhawks.
Take it around the horn once or twice, but it's still quite early. I think they'll start looking for about 15 seconds. It's at 15 now. They'll start looking. They're setting up an offensive scoring play right now.
Kansas doesn't mind playing Wake Forest style now, do they? With a 9-point lead and under 4 minutes to play. Here is Pollard from the baseline, just as the horn sounded, that they used all 35 seconds. Duncan with his 13th three-blanket, 14 rebounds for Duncan. And Trelawney Owens lost the ball. And Wake Forest frustrated, committing the foul on Jock Vaughn. It's the 17th foul, so Vaughn will shoot 1-1. Childress. So Childress and Owens have to be the two most frustrated players on the court, and rightfully so.
Yes, but Childress is hurt. That left arm, if you get a close shot of him, you see the left arm, how he's holding it on Childress. Owens just had bad shot selection. He's trying to score from 15 feet out. This game's 3 feet from the rim.
Between them, Childress and Owens have averaged 35 points a game. Today, they have 14. Vaughn, 1-1.
Got hope, but not a lot of hope. 3:33 left.
10-point lead, 60-50. That's the biggest lead. Kansas has missed only one free throw today.
Normally, they're a poor free throw shooting team. As a team, they shoot 63%.
But not today, and I think it was Richard Scott who hit the first free throw. Remember, he was 47%, and he's 2-for-2 in the game. So he set the tone. Wake Forest a little frustrated now, as well he should be, down by 11.
Today in America, over 11,000 babies will be born. 2.6 million people will go to the movies. 5 million parents will drop their kids off at daycare. And 36 million of us will get where we need to go in a Chevrolet. Think about it. 36 million. It's just another day in America. And more people will depend on Chevrolet than anyone else.
Finding work. It's the ultimate test students face. At ITT, we had a vision. Better teaching and facilities would lead to better students, which would lead to better jobs. And that's what led us to invest over $35 million in ITT technical institutes. It's nice to know our investment is working. ITT, we're adding more than just our name.
Dean Witter believes every investor's success story is unique. From getting in on the ground floor to getting all the way to the top, Dean Witter can help you make it every step of the way.
We measure success one investor at a time.
Then you flip the hat. You're late and you got the wrong hat. Sit in the corner.
Ooh, no respect at all.
Then you raise the hat.
Hey, this thing's still alive.
Wrong hat. Then you slam the hat. Then you bend the hat.
Oh, I need landing instructions.
Wrong hat. Then you smooth the hat.
Take it easy, will you? I think I'm having a hat attack.
You need the right hat.
It's your star hat.
Now I'll get some respect.
Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Look to us for a special delivery. Call us. We'll arrange to pick you up at your home, office, or repair shop. That's special delivery. That's Enterprise.
A young detective.
On the ground!
A seasoned partner.
All that. One cup of coffee a day.
And a living legend. March 31st. Get set for Traps.
Purdue has advanced to the Sweet 16, as will the winner of this game. And an interested observer, well, I don't know, engrossed in watching his next opponent is Glenn Robinson of Purdue.
Oh, he's so happy with himself. He got his championship Big Ten hat on, and he's playing Game Boy. What else do you want in life?
You've seen Game Boy. Doesn't your grandchildren play that?
Oh, boy, they're, anytime I need the TV fixed or set, I call my grandchildren. How do you do it? Got to score from three-point land now, a must.
Wake Forest has only scored 1 point in the last 6 minutes. Owens is fouled after they took the lead of 49-48 with 9 minutes remaining. They have only scored a point. Banks will come in, and Owens will go to the free throw line with 3:15 to play. The foul is going to be called against Pollard, his third. Here's Banks, and going out is LaRue.
Trying to get a little bit more strength down low.
Owens, 1-for-13 shooting, and that's his third point of the game.
Oh,
Soliloquy from Macbeth.
Or from Carousel, if you're more modern. Rodgers and Hammerstein. Owens hits both free throws. Wake Forest down by 9. Not out of the game yet, by any means. With 3:13 to play.
There goes the Roadrunner.
He beat everyone down court. Jacques Vaughn now with 10 points. 7 of them here in the second half.
Got to answer immediately. Don't let me too many ticks off the clock.
Here's Duncan. He's been in playing for several minutes with 4 fouls and a foul. Scott pushed Owens. And that'll be the 17th foul against the Jayhawks. So Owens will go to the line to shoot 1-1.
That's where Owens should have been all day. Down low there. That's where you're great. That's what made you a super ball player. Down low. Doing the dirty work down there.
So here is Owens, who has had a struggling tournament here in Lexington. Wake Forest shooting 35% from the field, and Owens a big part of that with only one basket.
Not struggling from the charity line. He makes this one. He still keeps their hopes alive.
Averaging over 15 on the year today. He's got 5. 1 out of 2. And that 10-point difference in Owens happens to be what the scoreboard shows, with Kansas leading. Driving in and missing was Woodberry, and followed in by Pollard with 13 points, 8 here in the second half. Here is Childress, misses a 3, and off to the races is Jacques Vaughn. And the foul called against Childress. 2:32 to go, and a 12-point lead for Kansas. And now you can start to pack the bags of the red and blue, and they can head for Knoxville as well. And no stranger to advancing in the tournament. Last year, of course, Kansas lost to North Carolina in the Final Four, lost in the finals to Duke 3 years ago, and won the title with Danny Manning back in 88. Banks is out, and LaRue is in for Wake Forest.
Roy Williams, one of the best, if not the best, coach of the second wave. These other coaches start to leave now, the Lute Olsons and the John Thompsons and the Bobby Knights and the Dean Smiths. That's the man. He is the leader of the second wave. I feel like I'm talking about his substitutions, where he throws them in waves. A lot of his philosophy has come from Dean Smith. A lot of your great coaches, gang, out there, remember this, never really played basketball. They were subs. Bobby Knight was a sub. Dean Smith was a sub. Rick Majerus was a sub. They were guys that learned their game sitting on the bench. They're students of the game. Luke on a second.
Lucas with a reverse layup. Rebound by Pearson, 66 to 53. Winding down to 2 minutes remaining, Kansas will advance to the Sweet 16, and here is a foul. Well, look at Roy Williams out. Many of you know we're playing, of course, in Rupp Arena. Rupp played for Kansas, and on the day he died in December of 77, Kentucky played in Lawrence. And Adolph Rupp asked to listen to that game on radio, and on Thursday, Roy Williams visited Adolph Rupp's gravesite, and he rubbed the basketball on his tombstone. So Roy Williams, with Dean Smith, knows what the tradition of basketball here is in Lexington and around the country.
Talk about starting at the bottom. Roy started as a graduate assistant. His job was to run the films for the camps that Dean Smith was running throughout the state of Wisconsin, out the state of North Carolina.
Here's Childress with the ball. Steal by Ritchie. Here's Vaughn. Leaving it for Woodberry. They're going to use the clock with 1:43 remaining. And the foul called against Lucas of Wake Forest. And that'll be the 10th team foul. And he'll be shooting on the line 2 shots. Lucas with his 4th foul.
Number 34, Richard Scott. Bob will step to the line and shoot 2.
Kansas Jayhawks are a minute and 39 seconds away from advancing to the Sweet 16 and a date with the top-seeded Purdue Boilermakers in Knoxville. They were trailing by 6 points early in the half, but their depth and strength paid off, and they wore out Wake Forest, leading here by 13 with a minute 39 remaining.
For Wake Forest checking in 13.
Anderson will replace LaRue. Wake Forest has been kept in the game by freshman center Tim Duncan, who has scored 16 points, but they did not get the offensive production today from Trelawney Owens and Randolph Childress, who have scored 17 points between them after averaging 35 in the regular year.
Guys from Lawrence just had too much off the glass, too much height, and too many players.
Kansas lost in the Final Four last year, nearly a steal. You know, they're trying to avert a recent trend. Even years, they've lost in the second round, but in odd years, they've gone to the Final Four. They're trying to reverse that. And they've held Wake Forest to 34% shooting. Woodberry, the leading scorer, with 16. 67-53. Wake Forest hung in as long as they could with a 7 or 8-man group. But Woodberry, their leader, no turnovers today, even though Kansas did turn it over a lot in the first half. Vaughn is fouled. So Kansas will go 27-7 on the season, and they will advance to the regional semifinals against Purdue, which has lost only 4 games this year.
And they've got to take on the number one ball player in the country. That will be war.
You're talking about Glenn Robinson, who after who scored 30 points or more 8 straight games, had 33 points today and leading Purdue to a victory over Alabama. And Childress, the junior, out of the game. He fouled out, having scored 12 points, 5 boards, 5 assists.
He's hurting. That left arm is hurting. He couldn't play with that left arm the last 11 minutes of the game. Courageous young man.
Remember, he had that partial dislocation of that left shoulder, suffered before the ACC tournament, and that's what's bothering him, and he gets a pat on the back from Dave Odom.
He's kind of stoic type person, never shows emotion. Team player all the way.
A lot of guys wouldn't even go with an injury like that. Nearly a minute remaining. LaRue with a 3. 11-point lead with less than a minute remaining. Wake Forest will finish at 21-12 on the year. And LaRue having to foul. Last year, Wake Forest lost to Kentucky in the Sweet 16. Actually, the semifinals by 34 points.
Well, they took on a giant. They used to giants in the ACC conference. They played Duke twice and North Carolina 3 times. Let me tell you something about the ACC. One of the big high school games coming up after the year. There are 22 of the best high school ball players in the country. 7 haven't made their mind up where they're going. 7 are going to the ACC, and the other 7 are going to the rest of the country.
By the way, our Chevrolet players of the game are Tim Duncan from Wake Forest with 16 points and 14 rebounds, and Steve Woodberry of Kansas. He has 17 points and on the line right now, 7 assists and 0 in the turnover department.
Checking in number 33, Greg Gerber.
Hand for Woodberry as he leaves the game, but we'll be seeing him in Knoxville, the senior and the best all-round player for Woodberry. Only Danny Manning and Chris Piper have played in more NCAA tournament games than Woodberry, who will be playing in at least one more.
Woodberry's biggest stat is he's shooting 41% from three-point land.
Air ball thrown up by LaRue with 39 seconds. And they're going to empty their bench right now. Wake Forest and Kansas. Smile on the face of Roy Williams. You'll survive and advance. That's the battle cry for Kansas. Survive and advance, and that's what they've done today.
That comes from my buddy of the last year, Jimmy V, Jimmy Valvano. That's all he ever said in any NCAA. Survive and advance.
LaRue hits the jumper. Wake Forest has only 2 baskets in the last 9 minutes and 15 seconds after they took their last lead at 49-48. Kansas took over in the second half. Turnover with 18 seconds to go. Substitutions for the Jayhawks. Final seconds of the game. 3-point attempt is missed by Whitebrock. And the game is over. Kansas has advanced. Final score, the Kansas Jayhawks 69, Wake Forest 58. When we come back, it'll be Jim Nance in our New York studios as the Big Eight has moved on.
You may have made a difference in someone's life. We can't tell you their name or anything about them. We can tell you that by using or being a designated driver like 80 million other Americans, you've made a very real contribution. You see, drunk driving fatalities declined by 32% in the last 10 years. We salute America's designated drivers, and we urge everyone to join you. By doing what's right, you're making things better. A message from Anheuser-Busch.
Imagine adhesives so strong they help hold together 100 tons of soaring transportation. Imagine a fabric so bright it lets you see an accident in time to prevent it. Imagine a single disc so powerful it can store everything imaginable and protect it for a lifetime. These products and thousands more that make our lives better exist because the people at 3M imagine.
Yeah, this is nice. Like the seats. Lots of room, that's good.
Whoa.
Lots of room back there, too. Ride smooth. Real smooth. Ah, they must have fixed this road.
Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Like even when it's just barely a road at all.
Barbecue chicken sandwich is a hit. Folks love our tangy honey barbecue sauce.
Russ, $1.49 barbecue chicken sandwich forever.
Not quite. The $1.49 is for a limited time.
We do chicken right.
Genuine jockey.
Real quality. Real fit. No wonder guys feel comfortable with jockey.
Genuine jockey, yeah.
This week on Dave, Bill Cosby, Diane Sawyer, Neil Diamond, Elle McPherson, and Rosie O'Donnell. This week.
It's big. Wow. All right, three teams in the Sweet 16, Purdue, Kansas, UConn, Big 10, Big 8, Big East. Three more games coming up next. Maryland, UMass, Wisconsin, Green Bay, Syracuse about the tip. Penn against Florida. We'll continue on the road after this word from your local station.
You expect from the country that invented rock and roll.
The great masters defined civilization in Europe. Now we're defining it on the way there. United Airlines' renowned international service to 15 cities all across Europe. Come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies.
This is CBS.
Introducing the Relationship Loan from Fort Wayne National Bank. New customers can borrow at a low 6.9% APR. If you have a checking or savings account or open one, it's 6.8 APR. Checking and savings, 6.7 APR. And if you have a checking, savings, and any other loan with us, you can borrow at an unbelievable 6.5% APR. See, it really does pay to bank with us.
Fort Wayne's my city, and that's my bank.
The Relationship Loan. The better we know you, the better it gets. Only at Fort Wayne National Bank.
It lights our day, warms the land and water, and gives life to our planet. The sun's energy is a vital resource. It's stored in the soil and groundwater around your home. By tapping into this free energy, the geothermal heating and cooling system can save its owners up to 35% on the heating and cooling costs of their new or existing home, which makes geothermal the smartest heating and cooling system on Earth. To learn more about geothermal, call I&M's marketing department.
Here's the bottom line on compact trucks. Chevy's all-new S-Series offers a longer truck with more headroom. more standard available horsepower, and greater standard payload capacity than Ford's Ranger. Chevy also features a deeper, wider, and more spacious cargo bed, plus a special anti-chip paint process not available on any Ford or Toyota. And for the first time, get a $300 rebate on the all-new Chevy S-Series. Drive one today and see why everything else is history. Only from your Northeast Indiana Chevy dealers.
Coda Kid 94, this Saturday and Sunday at Southtown Mall.
All right, one more time. Maryland, UMass, tips in 5 minutes. Wisconsin, Green Bay, Syracuse, about a minute away. If you're expecting Penn, Florida, that's 20 minutes away from tip. We'll start you out with coverage of Green Bay and Syracuse as we continue on the road in just a moment. Stay with us.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevrolet, O'Doul's, and by Pennzoil Motor Oil.
There are over 3 million miles of roads in America. And if you're on any one of them, Chevrolet will be there. Our genuine customer care program will take care of you with a 3-year, 36,000-mile warranty, 24-hour roadside assistance, a 6-year, 100,000-mile corrosion protection, free courtesy transportation if your car ever needs service, and the largest dealer network in the country. That's genuine customer care. Genuine Chevrolet.
Playing hard can be hard work for your back. So don't get caught without the support you need. Get a Sealy Posturepedic. Unlike other premium coils, Sealy's patented Sense and Respond coils give easily at first for comfort. Then, as weight increases, respond with increasing support. Correct support. And only Sealy has these patented steel beams, not wood. No wonder it's endorsed by so many great athletes. Posturepedic support, only from Sealy.
You've got the winning color!
Make your engine last longer. Change your oil every 3,000 miles and use the newest Pennzoil. Now with a revolutionary Pennstar molecule, Pennzoil works like liquid ball bearings. Clings in, on, around, and between moving parts to reduce heat, friction, and wear like no other motor oil.
My car's got 295,000 miles on it.
It has 161,000 miles.
314,000.
173,000.
Pennzoil has always stood by me. It's never failed me.
You got the winning color!
Green Bay and Syracuse, and off the court, Nordgaard, who was the leading scorer in their opening victory over California, 24 points, had 9 boards along with it. Tim Ryan and Ann Myers here in Ogden, Utah. We are in the opening minute, no score. The number 12.